What was it like to be alone in the lab when you made that discovery? It could be a line or two, but that's a story. That's a way to take a specific bit of knowledge that you're trying to convey and tie it to an emotion, tie it to a mental image.
You can use stories to bring your audience with you to that moment. When thinking about your research talk, you know, there's definitely thinking about what is the story arc or the logical flow of the research talk. But there's also stories that can happen within a talk. You know, we like to call them vignettes, little story vignettes.
Experiences you had maybe in the lab or maybe doing field work or something that relates to your data or your experience that helps bring some aspect alive.
So these little vignettes, you string them together to then build the full story of your talk. Sometimes we talk about that aha moment, a result that you see all of a sudden. It's that result that you've been looking for.
I would always talk about my happiest day in graduate school, which is when I did an experiment late at night in a dark microscope room. I was by myself, no one else was in lab, and I had just done this experiment a little bit on a whim because I didn't think it was going to work, and it basically supported my hypothesis and was the experiment, and I just remember that feeling of excitement.
Stories about who could be impacted and how can get people to really care about your story and your research, like sharing the story of a patient who perhaps is suffering from a disease for which there is no treatment or cure.
Everybody is struggling with something. Any story of struggle is, in my opinion, easily relatable.
If you were working in the field, like say that you're in a forest and you're trying to find this particular animal that's really, really small, and you're walking for miles and miles, and then eventually you found it. Or maybe you didn't find it. It took you 3 days. You know, tell us about that. There are different storytelling techniques that you could use.
It could be, you know, as simple as just kind of painting a scene to understand the circumstances.
Along the riverbank, you can see these beautiful, bright, iridescent moths. You can see butterflies sipping up muddy water and gathering minerals. And if you're really lucky, you can see this peculiar sight of butterflies actually mobbing a turtle head and sipping up its tears.
A really helpful way for using story could be to make a seemingly very impersonal and inaccessible subject be very much relatable and personal.
When I cut my finger this fall cutting sweet potatoes, I opened the skin unintentionally and introduced bacteria from the environment into my body. Now, the reason that I didn't get an infection from those bacteria is because I have white blood cells whose job it is to go around my body and engulf bacteria to remove them. Now, not all of the white blood cells in my body live in my fingertip. They live all over, and their job is to go to wherever the bacteria are whenever bacteria get introduced.
I thought that was just a really clever way to understand the concept of gradient tracking, you know, which can be hard for even expert audiences to understand. You could use story as a means to try to build empathy for your subject.
You've got your face in the water. It's silent because your ears are filled with water. All you hear is your breath resonating in the snorkel. And then you start to just watch the sharks slowly swimming by you. You then notice that all the sharks have a different spotting pattern that's as unique as a fingerprint. They're beautiful, beautiful animals.
Many people, not surprising, are scared of sharks. Leopard sharks actually don't attack people, and that's the information that Andy was really trying to convey.
When you're thinking about what are the vignettes, like what are the little stories that you're going to weave into your talk, something to think about is going back to your goal, your message, and your audience. That's going to help you choose what information is essential. So it's gonna help you choose which vignettes are going to tell the best story so that you can meet the goals that you you established, so that you can deliver that core message to reach that audience effectively.